T. Burke, the Director of Children's Ministry and Adult Education, and Pastor Jerry here at Springfield FUMC. We thought it'd be fun for Valentine's Day to do a little game where we have to guess if a song is a secular love song or a Christian love song.
Are we ready?
Yes, we're ready. You ready to lose?
I'm gonna win.
Okay, we'll see.
Okay.
Put your thinking caps on, and here's the first lyric. Hold me close. Let your love surround me. Christian or secular?
Christian.
I'm well with Christian.
Ding, 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 ding. It is Hillsong, The Power of Your Love. Yay, a Christian or secular? I feel like moving to the rhythm of your grace. Your fragrance is intoxicating in a secret place.
That's Christian.
That's Christian.
Ding, ding, ding.
Got
it. Your Love is Extravagant by Casting Crowns.
And I'll let you have that.
Okay.
But when you put your arms around me, there's nothing in this world I can't do.
Secular. I said that first.
Okay, there's no points here. You're right, it is secular. That is Keith Urban, Somebody Like You. Secular or Christian? I'm on my knees, begging you to notice me. I'm on my knees.
Secular.
Christian.
Ding, 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 ding. It is Christian. It's 10th Avenue North, Hold My Heart. Okay.
I got it.
You're a pastor. You should get it.
Yeah, I should get all of them.
Yeah,
okay. And next we have, And I Hope Life Treats You Kind. I hope you have all you dreamed of.
What song is it?
I'll Always Love You, Dolly Parton.
Whoa, it's Whitney Houston.
Dolly did it first. Dolly wrote it and made all the money.
Okay, but Whitney's the one that like got it good. She like got
she
notes
won, like,
in there.
All, she won all
How's
the
it
awards.
Go?
I can't do Whitney.
Hey, you can.
Can't
if
do
anyone
Dolly
can
either.
Do it, it can be you.
No.
Yeah.
Why don't you do it?
We'll always love you.
That's a great imitation.
Yay!
Maybe it'll be my next job.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see here. What about pointing me on my way into your loving arms?
Ooh.
That's Christian.
I'll agree with the pastor.
Ding, 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 ding. God Bless the Broken Road by Selah. It's done by several other artists, but they made
you
it.
Like Christian, you like the Christian music, too.
Good job, buddy.
He was cheering me on. I was your child, but he was cheering me on.
I'm
pretty
me. Sure
I'm
he was just
PJ.
Singing.
I miss PJ.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, of course.
All right, now. Here we go, another one. If tomorrow was Judgment Day, and I'm standing on the front line, and the Lord asked me what I did with my life.
That's Christian.
Second.
Abby's wrong. Pastor Jerry's right. It's Whitney Houston. My Love Is Your Love. Okay.
You gonna sing that one for us?
I don't know it really. I just guessed. Okay. I guessed.
Okay.
It was
too obvious.
Churchy that it could be the other one.
Yeah.
I tried to pick ones that could be either way. Okay, so here's the next lyric. Christian or secular? Walk through fire for you. Just let me adore you.
Go to secular.
I'll say Christian.
Ding, 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 ding. Abby's yes. Right. Pastor Jerry's wrong. It is Harry Styles, Adore You.
I let you
should
have
had that.
I let
it's
you
Harry
have
Styles.
That.
How do you not
Grace
know
is a big
Styles.
Harry Styles fan. I let you have it.
Grace is going to be disappointed.
She'll admire the fact that I let you have it.
All right, next one is... Moving
we're
on.
Trying to be serious.
But do you know there's a place you belong? Here in my arms.
That's secular.
It could be God.
Say secular, Christian. You don't have to explain.
Maybe I'm an external processor.
An external processor?
Yeah, that's the thing.
I said secular.
Pocket three.
I'm going to go with Christian, just to not be Pastor Jerry.
And Abby is correct. It is third day. Call my name.
I should have processed it.
It is actually like God or Jesus talking to us. No. There's a place you belong.
See?
Yeah.
That's what I said.
Okay.
So now, next one, Christian or secular. You take me to a place that's safe and warm. You're my harbor in the storm.
Christian.
Thanks, Christian.
Well, it could be either one, so you would have both been right. That was a freebie. It's finally. It's sung by T.G. Shepherd. However, it was written by Gary Chapman, Christian artist.
Okay.
Take me to your heart, for it's there that I belong. Secular or Christian?
Thank you, Christian, so I'm going secular.
I'll say secular.
You're both right. It was Love Me Tender by Elvis.
Should have known
that one
quicker.
Elvis. Hey, listen, I scoured these song lyrics. Okay. Because nothing on earth is as beautiful as you.
Secular.
Christian. Mm. You've already answered. You can't change it. It's Christian.
Abby's wrong. Pastor Jerry is right. It is Jeremy Camp. Beautiful one. All right. So let's see.
You just went the opposite of me.
Yeah, I'm usually right.
Sometimes.
Usually sometimes.
Okay, this is kind of long, so listen carefully. 3 a.m, and I'm still awake. So I picked up a pen and a page. I started writing just what I'd say if we were face to face.
That's Christian.
Sidewalk Prophets, the words I would say. Ding, 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 ding. Okay. And when I knew I had to face another day, Lord, it made me feel so tired.
That's secular.
He seems confident, so I'll agree.
Secular it is. You make me feel like a natural woman, Aretha Franklin. It's a good song.
When was it written?
Back in the 60s. Who was the writer?
Born in 95.
All you people out there that know, Carole King wrote that. Make me feel like a natural woman. There you go, you young lady, you.
No, sounds like your jam.
I'm not a man.
We have one more. Y'all have done very well. My heart is holding on to you from the moment I knew.
I'll say Christian.
I was secular.
Abby's right. Pastor Jerry's wrong. It is Sarah Pareles, The Light. I think that's all I got. So since there are no points,
Abby wins.
It doesn't matter. Yes, Abby. No, Aaron wins. Aaron wins.
Wasn't this fun?
Yeah.
All to say that we love you and Jesus loves you.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Happy Valentine's Day.
Hey, y'all. It's Abby Tieber.
Good morning. My name is Kevin Uner. I'm the lay leader here at Springfield First United Methodist Church. I want to welcome you to our service time together. Whether you are here as a regular attender or as a visitor, or you're going to join us by Facebook or YouTube later, we are just glad that you have chosen to come and worship with us, no matter where you are and when you are joining us. So it is really nice to look out here and see a whole lot of human beings this week. I'm glad that you all braved the weather to try to get here this morning. I hope that you did it without too many difficulties anyway. So interestingly, I was sitting here, you know, watching that video, having some chuckles, and the first thing I thought was, there's always points. Somebody is always keeping score. But it was really nice to see see our staff sort of jest and joke. And one of the things that really struck me by that is how much, regardless of whether, you know, the lyrics or books or whatever are branded as secular or Christian, how when you take those lyrics in certain context and you put them into the right spirit, they all can point to Jesus and to our Lord. Every single one of those could, if you look at it through the right lens and through the right frame of reference. So I have just a couple of announcements and then some prayer concerns I want to lift up this morning. The church office will be closed tomorrow for President's Day. We're still planning on having the United Methodist Women fundraiser brainstorming meeting on the 18th. That'll be at 7 o'clock via Zoom. The Stephen Ministry meeting that was planned for the 15th will not meet this time. And then next week, you can come hungry. We're going to have a sausage and biscuit sale to benefit the youth before the 9 o'clock and the 11 o'clock services next week. We do want to extend Christian sympathy to Clint Collins and his family in the passing of his mother, Pat Collins. That funeral was held on Wednesday. And then also want to lift up Sherry Black, who passed away yesterday. She runs Sherry's Florist, that oftentimes does a lot of our chancel flowers. And then we have several to continue to lift up in our prayers. Michelle Johnson, Hawk Ruth, Jim Oliver, he is recovering from gallstone removal surgery. Raymond Francis is hopeful to get hopeful to be able to come home from rehab this week. We want to continue to lift up John and Jan Lassiter, Mike Greta, Nita Laughlin, Sam Bagwell, who is Joseph's uncle, and Michelle Hebert, who is Joseph's cousin, and Susan Ross, Laura's sister, who's just had her fourth surgery for shoulder repair. And if you've ever known anyone that's done that, shoulders are a tricky joint. They take quite a bit of healing and recovery time, so continue to lift her up in your prayers as well. And I think that's all of my announcements for this morning, but I want to turn the mic over to Abby for a special announcement.
Good morning. You all may have noticed in the newsletter that this Sunday we are going to show a little appreciation to our Sunday school teachers. We have 14 adult classes here and just shy of 40 Sunday school teachers that plan lessons and show up early week after week after week to teach you all about the love of God. So we want to show them some love today and thought it was pretty fitting since today was Valentine's Day. So if you're a Sunday school teacher, we have freshly made coffee and a little gift for you right inside of the fellowship hall doors on the first floor in the other building. So either as you go to Sunday school or on your way out of Sunday school, if you would stop by the table and get a gift. I want to ask y'all a question. So if a Sunday school teacher at any point in your life has ever made a positive impact on you, please stand up. Teachers, you really do make a difference in people's lives. You might not feel like it some weeks. It might be hard. It might be exhausting, but you're changing lives with what you do. So thank you.
As Kevin said, we are glad you've chosen to join us for worship today. Looks like the week may get a little worse from here on out, but we're here this morning in a warm Moore Center, unlike last week when we were hauling the sanctuary because it was about 55 degrees in here. We'd had to dance and that might have gone against, well, I don't know, something. If you would stand with us, let's join our voices together this morning as we glorify our God and our King and our Savior, Jesus Christ.
We will glorify the Lord of glory.
He is the God of the universe, but he still takes time to care about us. He is the master potter, the master artist. As we continue to sing, join us in the potter's hand. singing, church. Be seated, please.
Amen. I've got to tell you, one of the things that I have really missed about us all being together is hearing all of you. So and I know that Shane has been singing to an empty room for the past couple of weeks, which is difficult in itself. But to know that we're all here together, praising the Lord together, being able to hear you and experience all of that together, it has truly just warmed my heart this morning. Will you pray with me this morning? Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning just excited that we're here together to praise and to worship you, that we're connected as a community of believers no matter where we are. And it's only that we're connected through you and through your love and through Jesus Christ that draws us together to you in this manner. Lord, today many of us will celebrate a secular holiday of Valentine's Day, but I pray that as we go through showing our care and our love to those that we care about with human love, that we also just take a minute today to recognize you as the source of pure love, of real love, a love that was demonstrated by sending your Son into human form to live, to be crucified, to rise again, just because you love us. And Lord, because of that love, we give back to you. We turn back our life. We ask you to mold us and to use us and to guide us and to lead us. Lord, your love is too big for us to hold in together. It's too big. It fills us up. It overflows. Lord, we need to share it with other people so that they can experience that same love, that they can understand the peace and the joy that comes from trading in all of those sorrows, trading in all of the pain, and trading it for the joy of serving and worshiping you. Lord, as we look at the weather forecast this week, we pray that you will keep us safe. We're reminded of the opportunity to reach out to other people that may not be able to get out, to make sure that our friends and our family and our neighbors are doing okay. But Lord, I also want us to just take a moment and just recognize the beauty and the majesty of your creation and be reminded as snow falls softly that your love surrounds us. All of this is in your hands. Lord, we've lifted up many, we continue to lift up many that are struggling with illness, that are struggling with sorrow. Lord, mend them. Make them better. Make them be whole again. Lord, lead us in the right direction, that we will follow your will. Lead us away from sinful behaviors. Let us be in reconciliation with you and your full love. Lord, it's in Jesus Christ's name that I pray all of these things, whose life was an example of perfect love. It's in his name we pray. Amen.
When I look back at what I thought was living, I'm amazed at the price I chose to pay. And to think I ignored what really mattered, 'cause I thought the sacrifice would be too great. But when I finally reached the point of giving in, found the cross was calling even then. And even though it took dying to survive, never felt so much alive. For I am crucified with Christ, let my hands surrender to His piercing purpose that holds me to the cross, yet sets me free. Gain a count as loss, and with this suffering I identify, and by His resurrection by alive. I am crucified with Christ, and yet
amen. Can you feel His presence today? I feel it. The warmth of His love and grace is with us today. Let's give the Lord a hand for His servants. It's so good to look out and see you and be together in worship. There's even more people here today, I think, Kevin, than there were last week. We also don't want to forget that we still have our Facebook and YouTube audience, and we're glad that you are with us as well. Our scripture lesson for the day comes from the second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 4, verses 7 through 18. Follow on the screen or in your own scriptures. But we have this treasure in jars of clay to show that this all-surpassing power is from God and not from us. We are hard-pressed on every side, but not crushed, perplexed, but not in despair, persecuted, but not abandoned, struck down, but not destroyed. We always carry around in our body the death of Jesus so that the life of Jesus may also be revealed in our body. For we who are alive are always being given over to the death of Jesus' sake so that His life may also be revealed in our mortal body. So then, death is at work in us, but life is at work in you. It is written, I believe, therefore I have spoken. Since we have that same spirit of faith, we also believe and therefore speak, because we know that the one who raised the Lord Jesus from the dead will also raise us with Jesus and present us with you to Himself. All this is for your benefit, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God. Therefore, we do not lose heart. Though outwardly we are wasting away, but inwardly we are being renewed day by day. For our light and momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. So we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen, since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternal. It's the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. As Kevin stated earlier, today is Valentine's Day. And this holiday is approached in multiple different ways, and I think you did an excellent job, Kevin, talking about our relationship with God and how God loves us. Can we give the Lord a hand for the way He shared the love of God with us this morning? I think I shared with you a few years ago about forgetting Valentine's Day 1 year. Did I share that with you? Probably. I've been here long enough, I'm repeating myself. But 1 year I forgot Valentine's Day. Yeah, whoops is right. And after some time, it was acknowledged by my spouse. I love you, honey, if you're watching this morning. So they're taking care of the grandbaby this morning. No card, no candy, no flowers, no dinner. I forgot. But right in the midst of all that forgetfulness and trying to make up for it, something welled up with inside me. And this is what I came up with. Now, I'm not saying it worked, but I said, every day is Valentine's Day with you, baby. It didn't work. But you know, if you think about it, every day is a day of love with God and us, right? It's a day of love that we have an opportunity to share with each other, and ultimately we are called to share the love of God with each other, not just that love that the world talks about, but that love that God gives us. So it is a special day. Last week I talked about how no one compares to God. And we learn that God has a desire to take care of us. I talked about how we are called to put our trust and our hope in God so that we might be renewed, refreshed, re-energized, and strengthened. And I talked about those that trust in the Lord have the ability to soar like eagles. And I talked about how we have the opportunity to make a decision. Do we peck the ground like chickens? Or do we soar like eagles? What'd y'all do this week? Did you soar like eagles or did you peck the ground like chickens? I think I did a little of both, off and on. I want to soar. But sometimes in the midst of my circumstances, I find myself pecking the ground like chickens. But God is still with us. God helps us to soar. God helps us to experience what He has for us. The scripture talks about, today's scripture, 2 Corinthians chapter 4, talks about how we have God's great mercy in our lives. It talks about how we are not alone. It talks about how we are undergirded with the power of God. Excuse me. It talks about how God's mercy is with us and that we should not lose heart. There are many reasons why we should not lose heart, and we'll get into those in just a moment. But in the scriptures, he talks about how our lives are different because of Jesus. He talks about how our lives are not according to the old way of living, but because of the way of Jesus, our lives are different and our lives can be approached differently. We share Christ and the truth of the gospel given to us in the midst of what the world says about life in general. So we have a gift that God has given us, a gift that helps us to realize that we are called to persevere through hardships and not lose heart. My humble assistant, Laura, would you give her a hand? She even opened it for me. Wow, Laura.
She'll expect me to be nice to her all week, probably, don't you think? Yeah, okay. Yeah, she does. She does a great job. The scriptures tell us that we are instruments of God. But the funny thing about it is, as we look at this scripture, it says that we're instruments of God, but we're clay jars. Clay jars are fragile. Amen? Clay jars are fragile. If we were to pick up this beautiful clay pot here and drop it on the floor, it would probably break, or at least crack. We're not going to do that as a demonstration today. But it's a fragile thing, clay jars. And the scripture today talks about how we're clay jars and how, as we are fragile, the power of God resides within us. And it talks about how we are clay jars, how we are fragile individuals, so that the power of God will be manifested in us and be seen in and through us. Because if we weren't fragile, there might be a veil between us and our witness to others. We are fragile. We've got things going on in life. God is working in our lives with strength and with power. So yes, we're fragile. Mark Lowry, Christian comedian and great writer, who wrote Mary, Did You Know? He's this silly, goofy Christian comedian, and then he turns around and writes Mary, Did You Know? Had some words about this. He said, we're all falling apart. Would you agree with that? We're all falling apart. When we pop and crack, when we stand up and everything hurts and all. And Mark Lowry said, we're all falling apart. We are under the attack of bifocals, bridges, bursitis, bellies, and bunions. He said, we're all under attack. We're falling apart. We're clay jars. But Paul makes sure that we all hear that because we're clay jars, we're called to die to ourselves each day so that the love and life of Jesus can be manifested within us. We are clay jars. We're fragile, but the power of God is in us. Amen? We are clay jars, and as Christians, we can realize that we are not insignificant, but we are individuals who hold a sacred trust, and the power of God is awesome and is a treasure for us to share. Despite our weakness and uncertainty about our lives, the powerful part of it is that God wants to use us. God wants us to be the witnesses that God has called us to be. This power is from God, and we get to be the witnesses to share that with everyone we meet. Some people say that Paul was saying that this treasure is the power of God. This treasure is the gospel of Jesus Christ. This treasure is the love of God manifested in and through us to others. And Paul shares that we should be relying on God and not losing heart. It's easy to lose heart these days, isn't it? It's easy with so much going on in life that we can lose heart. But Paul says we shouldn't do that. We should hold on to the fact that God is with us. He says that we should not fix our eyes on hardship, but instead fix our eyes on Jesus and focus on that special relationship that we have with Jesus. But as we look around the world today, it's easier. And it's simply a part of life where we want to focus on that. But Paul says, hang in there, folks. Don't lose heart. As we go through life, we ask a lot of why questions. Depending on what's going on in life, we wonder what's going on when life is turned upside down. We think about those things and we ask, why is all this happening? When we're in the midst of desperation, we worry about our families and the current situation among multiple things as we continue to deal with a pandemic. We ask questions of why. And I want to let you know that even as a pastor, I have to just rely on God's help. And I have to be honest with John or whoever I'm talking to and give you the most honest answer I can. I don't know. But God's with us, John. And that's the best I can do. And hold on to the fact that God doesn't want us to lose heart. All I do know is that God is real and can use situations that we're involved in to bring us closer to God and to each other. God wants to love us through our pain and through our hardships and remind us that regardless of what's going on, there is hope. And through the power of the Holy Spirit, Paul tells us that our beings are being renewed and that there is a way out of every situation. I love the way how Paul tells in this passage about the different things that we might think would bring hopelessness. He says, we're hard-pressed on every side, but we're not crushed. We're hard-pressed on every side, but we're not crushed. The walls may seem like they're closing in, but we're not hemmed in. Amen? Daily issues, stresses, change, various things are going on, but we have this treasure in clay jars. It may feel like things are closing in on us, but it's not over because God is here to help us. Paul says, we may be perplexed, but we're not in despair. We may be at our wits' end, but we're not at hope's end. The hope of Jesus Christ is still with us. It's in these times that I find myself going to the Serenity Prayer, and I know many of you have heard that, but I want to share that with you. And so many times you'll see the Serenity Prayer printed in its brief version, but I want to share the whole prayer with you today. A lot of times you'll see, or maybe you have one on your wall that says, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. And usually that's what the plaque will say that you buy at Lifeway. But I want you to hear the full prayer. And as you think about how our lives can be perplexing, remember that we're not completely in despair because God is with us. The prayer says, God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. Living one day at a time, enjoying every moment at a time, accepting hardship as a pathway to peace, taking it as Jesus did, this sinful world as it is, not as I would have it. Trusting that He will make all things right if I surrender to His will, that I may be reasonably happy in this life and supremely happy with Him forever in the next. We're perplexed. We are perplexed, but we're not in despair. It's amazing that God knows exactly what to do. Yes, we're clay jars, and we're broken at times, or we're at least cracked at times. But God works in and through us.
Paul tells us that we are persecuted, but we're not abandoned. We may be persecuted by people, but we're not abandoned by God. We're never alone. Joan of Arc even said in her time, "It's better to die alone with God. His friendship will never fail me, or his counsel, or his love. In his strength I dare, and I dare until I die." We are persecuted, but we are never abandoned. Paul says, we may be struck down, but we're not destroyed. We may be knocked down, but we're not knocked out. God is always there to pick us up. So how do we survive? We don't focus on the issues. We focus on Jesus. We are being renewed because God's power and the life of Jesus is being manifested and glorified in our weakness. We are being renewed because life is flowing from our suffering. Not only flows in our lives, but it flows in and through the church. It flows in and through other individuals' lives because we hold on to Jesus. We're being renewed because God has sustained all of us and has not allowed our circumstances to overcome us. We're being renewed because we know that we will be raised to life out of all of this to share with Jesus forever. The results of it are that when we are not willing to lose heart, when we hold fast to Jesus, we will experience the grace and the thanksgiving that will flow out of our lives, and it will be so contagious that it can be shared with others. That's what it's all about. We are called to be His witnesses. And as we work hard not to lose heart, others will see that God is with us. God is with us in 2021. God will see us through all of our lives. We shouldn't ultimately lose heart because God is more powerful than our lives. A friend of mine, Randy Neal, posted something on Facebook that said, Oswald Chambers, who wrote My Utmost for His Highest, maybe you read that. He said, one of the blessed things about life is that we carry the kingdom on the inside. And that's what makes the outside lovely. And Randy Neal, my friend, said, I sure am blessed to be around a lot of lovely people. Let us pray. Holy God, we thank You for this time together. We're thankful, Lord, that You love us. We're thankful, Lord, that even as we are fragile and we're cracked and we're broken, You still want to be a part of our lives. You still show us the way to life. We ask, Lord, that You help us to realize that Your power and love is in us and that You are renewing our lives each day. Help us to realize, Lord, that You are there no matter what is going on and that You will help us. Help us to be the witnesses that You've called us to be. Help us to not lose heart. Turn Your eyes upon Jesus. Look full in His wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of His glory and grace. I say these things in the name of the Christ. Amen.
As we stand together to sing our closing song, It asks us to just come as we are, because if we wait around until we think we're fixed enough to present ourselves to God, we will never be able to present ourselves to a holy God. Let's stand together as we invite Him to come into our lives.
Thank you for being here today and sharing in our time of worship. It's my prayer that you heard from God, that God reminded you that you are loved and that you are cared for. Go now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, seeking to live well, to laugh often, and to love extravagantly, doing it all in Jesus' name. Amen.